Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back to Create8. Today I'm going to share 8 cards that I made using the May products that have been released by My Favorite Things. For the first card, I'm going to use the adorable little girl from the Beach Day stamp set. I'm going to stamp her, and by the way, I am using a black ink that is not going to smudge or smear. This is by My Favorite Things and it's called Licorice Black. And I have also stamped the castle and the flag, but I will not end up using them. So now I'm going to use my alcohol markers to color the image. And now that I have colored everything, I am going to cut out the image by using the matching dies. And now that my image is ready, I am going to go ahead and create the background. For that, I will be using this dynamic set, which is going to help me build a beach scene. So first of all, I'm going to use this rectangle, which is actually going to cut out the sand and the sea. So you can use it either way, upside down I mean, and I am going to cut out once from white cardstock and another time from blue cardstock. I am using my Big Shot machine here. And then I will end up with 4 different pieces, but you can match 2 of them together. So I will show you what I mean. And you end up creating 2 different scenes. They fit together like a puzzle. So the white is going to be the sand for me. You will see what technique I will do to make it look like realistic sand. And you see that you can end up having 2 different scenes. I am trying to decide which one of these shapes I am going to use for my card. And now I am going to do a technique on both my sand and my sea, which is going to make it look really realistic. So I'm going to grab my Versamark ink pad, and as you can see, I'm only adding some sticky ink on one side of the paper. Now I'm going to apply this embossing powder, which is very chalky, if you can see. And now when I heat set it with my heat gun, it's going to look as if it's the white wave at the end of my sea. So it's going to give that beautiful look. Now for the piece that is going to be the sand, I'm just covering it up completely with my Versamark ink. So now this is sticky and I'm going to apply embossing powder, which is golden sand. I'm going to make sure that I cover up everything, heat set it, and this is going to give a beautiful look. As always, you will find links to everything that I'm using today, including the embossing powders, down below in the description area. So you see how beautiful my sand looks at the moment, so now I can go ahead and assemble my card. I am going to decide where I want my little girl to be. And for my card base, I'm working on a white cardstock that's 4.25 by 5.5. I'm going to place the sand and my sea on top just to know exactly where I want to do the sky. And I'm going to do a technique with the stencil that is just released by My Favorite Things. And I know that this is a stencil that I will be using a lot. I always like to create cards with sky. And this is a great technique to create a nice sky with fluffy white clouds. So all I'm doing is just moving my stencil as I go towards the bottom of my card, and I'm applying with a blending tool just a little bit of distress ink. And I'm working with tumbled glass today, but I'm making sure that I don't load my blending tool with too much ink, otherwise it's going to be too dark and I just want to have a light, soft sky at the background. Now it's time to assemble my card. As you can see, I am using tape adhesive at the back of the other pieces. I'm going to stick down the sand and the sea on top. I am using foam squares at the back of my little girl and I'm going to stick here on my scene. And this is where I realized that I wanted to add just a little bit more on my card to make it more busy and to add the fun element. So I decided to go again with that same dynamic set that I used to create my scene. And this time I am using the palm tree leaves. I just used brown cardstock for the tree trunk and green cardstock for the leaves. To add a little bit of dimension and shading, I used my distress ink with a finger dabber, and I'm adding just a little bit of inking at the edges of all the leaves. Then I will go ahead and assemble everything on top of my card. For my sentiment, I used the sentiment from the same stamp set that says "You brighten my life," and I'm going to stamp it directly on top of my sky. To finish off my card and to make it just a little bit cuter, I'm going to add some polka dots on her swimming suit, as well as a few highlights. To do so, I'm using my white gel pen. And I hope you can see all the dimension and the shine on this card. For my second card, I'm going to use this dynamic set to create a shaker card, and first I'm going to separate everything, and then I'm going to use a frame from a previous release by My Favorite Things, and I believe this is Blueprints 32, and I am placing on top the flower just to have a general idea of where I want the flower to be, so that I know exactly where I want to cut out my hole. Once I'm happy with the placement, I am securing it down. I'm going to run it through my Sizzix machine, and now I have a nice panel to go on top of my shaker card. Now at the back of this hole, I'm going to add some tape adhesive, and I'm going to cover up that hole with some acetate. So I'm just sticking the acetate there. I'm going to cut out the excess, and I have my window ready. For my flower, I'm going to cut it out of these pattern papers. Now, I went through my stash and I found these pattern papers in orange and in red. I'm going to cut out twice this flower, so I end up having four of them. I want to stick the darker one on top of the other, and at the same time I want to add dimension, so you will be able to see underneath that flower. And this is why I am going to stick back to back together. So this way, when you turn it over, it's going to be the same color. Now for the other one, I'm going to stick it directly on top of my card. I am going to stick the stem at the very bottom, just underneath those petals there. And then I'm going to take the darker flower, and I'm going to use my fingers to add some curves on the end of the petals. This way it's going to add some dimension, and it's going to look more fun. And now I'm going to stick that on top of my other flower, and this way you will be able to see the color underneath, and it's going to look more full. Now I'm working at the back of my panel. I'm using some foam tape to go all around the window, and then I'm going to add some yellow sequins. And this is actually a mix I had in my stash forever. I can't really remember where I got it. And I am going to cover up the hole with some yellow pattern paper. I have also used another die from the same set, and I have cut out this ring, and I'm going to stick it at the very center of my flower, and this is going to give a more finished look to my flower. I'm also going to stick down the leaves, and I'm going to stick the solid leaf directly on top of my card, while on the other leaf I'm going to add a little bit of a curl, and then stick it just a little bit offset against the other leaf. So this way I get more dimension. You know I love dimension, so I have to add it to pretty much every card that I make. And since this is such a fun and happy flower, I decided to go with a yellow card base for my card. Again, this is a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5. My sentiment says "Hello there." I have stamped it on a white piece of cardstock and cut it out with one of the banners by My Favorite Things. And the sentiment comes from the Essential Sentiments stamp set that was released this month. And I think this is a lovely and bright card. And now let's move on to the third card for today. Now for this I am going to use one of the giraffes from the giraffe set. I'm going to stamp it with my black licorice ink pad, and again I'm going to stamp it on white cardstock. You see I'm just using a scrap here, and I'm going to use my alcohol markers to color it, and also the matching dye to cut it out. Now, as you can see, I didn't even bother to color the whole giraffe, just because I'm not going to use it as it is. Now, I'm also going to use this safari tree, and I'm going to cut out parts of it by using just some cardstock. Here I'm using two different shades of green for the leaves and dark brown for the trunk. And just because I want to have some clouds on my sky, I'm going to bring in those clouds from the Cloud 9 dynamic set. And now, as you can see, I'm planning to have my giraffe coming from behind the tree, so I'm just going to chop her off and I'm going to decide where I want her to go. I'm going to stick her down and then assemble my tree on top. For some of the leaves of the tree, I'm going to stick them directly on top of my card, and for some others I'm going to use a foam square at the back just to add a little bit of dimension. So now my giraffe looks even taller than it was designed to be, just because I have chopped her off in that way. And the idea is to have her way up high, and by sticking the tree trunk so far down at my card and sticking down the white clouds, it really gives the illusion that she's far, far up at the sky. Now for the sentiment, I will stamp what's up, and I'm going to stamp that on my cloud, and fits perfectly inside. The sentiment comes from the same stamp set as the giraffe, and now I'm going to stick the panel on a standard white card, and my card is finished. Now let's move on to card number 4. This time I'm going to use the seagulls and the waves. So these are grey dice. I'm going to place one on top of this cardstock and cut it out. And you can see here on top of my panel what a beautiful wave I got. And I have also stamped two of the seagulls, making sure that they look at each other. There are so many different designs of seagulls and you can play around with them. I am going to color everything with my alcohol markers. I'm using Spectrum Noirs here. Now, as you can see, my seagulls are ready and cut out, and I'm working on my sea right now. I'm going to add some slits on my sea where I'm going to place the seagulls inside as if they are floating at the sea. These dies that I'm using right now come from the matching dynamic set of the seagulls. So now I have some slits there, and I like how wavy they are, and my seagulls fit just right inside them. Now I have to stick down my seagulls. For that I'm going to use some foam squares at the back, and this way I am going to have some dimension. Now I'm going to stamp the sentiment, and for that I'm working directly on my card base, and I have combined two of the sentiments from the stamp set that say, "Hey girlfriend, I'm so glad you're mine, mine, mine." I think that's hilarious. Anyway, I am going now to stick the panel directly on top of my card base, and I am going to combine both tape adhesive as well as foam squares at the back, foam tape at the back, so that at the very bottom the panel is going to be flat on my card base, but at the top it's going to be just a little bit raised. Now to finish it off, I am going to add some hearts, and for that I just used a punch that I had forever. I have punched out a few of them. I'm going to place exactly where I want them, and then I'm going to go ahead and stick them down. I also did go ahead and added some eyelashes on the eyes of one of the seagulls just to turn her into a girl. Now I think I have lost the footage of that, so you will see a close-up look at the photos at the end. Now I am going over the beaks as well as the hearts with my glitter pen, and I am also going to go over them with my clear Nuvo drops just to add some shine. And now let's move on to a fun card with flowers. For that I'm using the doodle flowers. I'm going to stamp some of the stems and some of the flowers. I'm going to use my alcohol markers to color them. And since these flowers have this doodle design, it's really fun to go over some of the parts and add some dots. And that's just what I am doing here. I'm using my white gel pen to do so, and I'm just having fun adding dots in random spots with no reasoning really. And when I finish playing around, I am going to use the dies and cut out every little image that I have colored. Once I had everything cut out, I played around a little bit to decide where everything is going to go, and I wanted to have all the flowers in a row. So I am going to stick the stems directly on top of my card with adhesive, and I am going to add foam scores at the back of the flowers. And as I was sticking everything down, I decided that I wanted to have my sentiment underneath that rib strip. So this is where I had to unpeel the flower, just because I had to cut out everything. So I didn't make a mess, which was good. And now I'm going to place this there so that I can run it through my die cutting machine. If I had that foam squares with the flowers on top of my panel, I wouldn't be able to run it through. So now I'm going to bring in my machine, I'm going to run through this strip, which is really fun, and I'm going to show you at the end of this card what that does. So it's going to create that thing there, which the recipient has to rip off, so that the sentiment is revealed underneath. And I'm also going to show you how you can stamp the sentiment underneath, so that they are completely aligned. Now I'm sticking down all the flowers. And the panel that I'm working on is slightly smaller than a standard card, so now that I am bringing this card, which is bright, I get a nice border all around. I am going to stamp the sentiment on my card base, but I need to make sure that this is completely aligned with the strip that the recipient has to rip off. So I am going to place the panel just temporarily on top of my card base. I'm going to pick my sentiment. I'm going to place it on top of the strip, close the door of my Misty, I'm going to remove the panel, and now I am ready to stamp. For that I'm going to use just black ink. I'm going to stamp it there, so I went with "You make me happy." And now all I have to do is to stick the panel on top of my card base. For that I decided to go with my tape adhesive. Just make sure that you don't add tape adhesive at the back of that strip that the recipient has to rip off. Otherwise it's not going to peel off. So now I'm going to make sure that I align it nicely there. And my card is ready. And here is an example of what the recipient has to do to reveal the sentiment. Really fun! And now let's move on to the sixth card for today, a very pink and girly card. Now I'm going to use the Peekaboo square, which is going to leave a window on my panel, and at the same time is going to give a nice stitching all around that window. I don't know if you can see that here in the close-up look, but it gives a really beautiful detail. Now I'm going to use the adorable Beach Bunnies stamp set, and I'm going to choose one of the bunnies, and I actually chosen the biggest one, so I'm going to stamp that on a piece of white cardstock, and then I'm going to color it by using my alcohol markers. I am also going to add some dots on her dress just because I think it's so cute, and then I'm going to use the matching dies and cut her out. Now I have a square which is slightly bigger than the window there, so I am going to work on my scene. And again I'm going over the stencil with the clouds, and I'm creating my sky with nice puffy clouds. Again I'm just using the same technique as I did for the first card. And to complete my little scene, I want to have some grass, a hill, so I'm going to use this die to create this nice scalloped edge. I'm going to cut out a piece of that, which is going to be the grass. I'm securing it at the bottom of my square by using some tape adhesive at the back. From the same stamp set I have also cut out a little birdie and colored it yellow, and now I'm using the build a scene from the previous release, and I have also cut out a little tree just by using some brown cardstock and some green one. So I'm now going to go all over the window at the back, and I'm not going for a shaker card here, I just want to support that window so it doesn't fall when I mail it. I'm going to peel off the backing and stick it on top of my square. And now I can go ahead and assemble everything on top. I'm going to add a foam square at the back of my bunny, and I'm going to place the bunny as if it's coming out of that little scene and towards you. And I'm also going to stick the other elements such as the bird and the little tree. And now I'm going to stick the panel on top of a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5, and that's in pale pink. I'm going to add a little bit of black shine on the eyes and the nose. And I'm using my clear Nouveau Drops on her bow, just to make it shiny. Now all that's left to do is to stamp the sentiment, and for that I used one from the same stamp set. I'm going to white emboss it on top of this same pink cardstock, and I went with a sentiment that says, "Hey honey bunny." So I'm stamping it with Versamark ink. I'm going to apply white embossing powder, I'm going to heat set it and then cut it out with one of the banner dies. I have added a piece of foam tape at the back of my banner, and now I'm going to secure it on top of my card, and my card is finished. And now let's move on and create card number 7, where I will be combining 3 different stamp sets from this release. So first of all, I'm going to work on a mixed media paper here, just because I will be using my Distress Oxide inks later on. The stamps that I'm using come from the exquisite Ocean stamp set, and this is going to play the role of a coral. And once I have stamped it there, I'm going to stamp it again, but this time I'm going to use Versamark ink. This is going to turn this design into an embossable design, but just because I am planning to do some clear embossing at the end. And I'm going to explain why I do that. So again, I'm going to stamp one more design, and this time I'm going with green. And then I stamped it once more directly on top by using Versamark ink. Now I'm super happy with how the bottom of my ocean looks, so I will go ahead and apply my embossing powder. Now this embossing powder looks white, but it is clear, so once I heat set it, it's going to turn shiny and clear. And the beauty of this is that once I apply Distress Oxides on top, this is going to resist Distress Oxides, so no matter how much ink I apply on top, I will still get the vibrant colors. So now I am going with Broken China and Faded Jeans. I have smooshed them on my craft mat, applied some water, and now I am going to make sure that I have enough color on my card. And I already love how it looks, my ocean already looks beautiful, and you can see how that embossed areas resist the color, the ink. So now I'm going to heat set everything, and once everything dries, I'm going to repeat the same process. So again, I am dabbing my panel on the rest of the splashes that I still have on my mat. I am drying in between, and I'm going to do that a couple of times, until I'm happy with the outcome. Now I'm going to clean my surface there, and I'm going to go over that panel directly with my Distress Oxide inks. This way I'm going to intensify the color just a little bit more, but I'm not going to overdo it, as I don't want to lose all that beautiful texture that I have already achieved. And again, I'm not introducing any other color. Again, I'm just working with the 2 colors that I have on my background. I'm spraying on top of everything. This is going to make the ink that I have added on top to react with water, and it's going to make it oxidized and give that chalky finish. I'm also going to add some droplets of water and wipe everything with a paper towel. And I love how my background is looking. And now I'm going to work on my focal point. For that, I'm going to use the shark from the stamp set that is called Ocean Pulse. And again, I will work on mixed media paper just to make sure that it's going to take the ink nicely. Now, I am going to color everything with my finger dabbers and my Distress Oxide inks. So I am using Iced Spruce for a first layer all over my shark. Then I'm going to add just a touch of Broken China, but not all over the shark, just only at the bottom. And then I will move on to the next color of my Distress Oxide collection, and that's Faded Jeans, again only at the very bottom of my shark. And just because I don't want to have that white border all around, although it's not white anymore, anyway, I don't want to use the matching dyes. For that look that I am going for. So that's why I am only going to use my scissors to cut it out. After all, that's a very easy image to cut out. And finally, I'm using my figure dabber with distress ink, black soot, and I'm going all around the edges just to add a touch of shadow, which is going to help my shark stand out against my ocean. And I think this really looks stunning. It's probably my favorite from all the 8 cards that I made today. So I'm adding some foam squares at the back of my shark. I'm going to stick him on top of my panel. And before that, I decided to go ahead and stamp some fish. So I have a school of fish there, and these both come from the other stamp set, the one with the mermaids. So I'm going to stamp them with distress oxide, and I wanted to have that faded look as if they are far at the background. And again, I am using iced spruce and faded jeans, and I'm going to stamp my fish here and there at the background. And now I'm happy with how many fish are at my ocean, so my shark is not alone. I'm going to stick him on top. And now all that's left to do is to add the sentiment. For that, I am going to stamp the sentiment from the same stamp set as the shark that says, "You are Joesome." That's such a great card, and you can give it to a guy or a girl. Now I am stamping that with Versamarking. I have embossed it with white embossing powder and everything on top of a black cardstock, just because it's going to turn up really bold. I have cut it out by using one of the banner sentiments by My Favorite Things. I am adding some foam tape at the back, and then I'm going to secure that on top of my panel. I am going to make sure that I slide it towards one side, and I'm going to use my scissors to cut out the excess. And finally, I'm going to stick this panel by using foam tape at the back on top of a black card base, which helps all those colors to pop even more. And the more I see this card, the more I love it. Just a great card. And we have already reached card number 8, which is the last card for today. So now I am working with a mermaid's stamp set, which is just adorable, beautiful designs. I have picked up one of the mermaids that I really love, and I'm going to color her by using my alcohol markers. Before that, I'm going to stamp some of the corals and the seagrass, just to have some props ready to go for my card. Now for that, I am going to stamp them with Versamarking, and then I'm going to emboss them, red for the corals and green for the seagrass. So before heat setting everything, I'm going to stamp everything, apply the embossing powders. Now I'm ready to apply the green one, put everything back in, and of course I have dropped everything outside of the jar, but let's say that that never happened. I'm going to continue as normal. I'm going to stamp the school of fish, and I'm going to emboss one with yellow and the other one with orange. So you see, I'm working with many different embossing powders, but I don't mix up the colors at all. Now I'm going to apply the yellow one, put that back on in the jar, and then I'm going to bring in my heat gun to heat set everything, and of course clean the mess. I have colored my mermaid, and I'm going to give her star shine. I'm using my glitter gel pens there. And now I will work on my background, and I'm going to show you a fun technique that you can do, which is going to give you a totally different look than the ocean that we did previously. So I'm going to use the mermaid tail background, and I'm going to go over it with the large tip of my Nuvo glue pen. I'm going to apply, instead of ink, glue. I am applying my cardstock on top and quickly taking it off, and you can see that I get that beautiful design. Now I'm going to spray my stamp with water, and I'm going to wash it with warm water and soap. And my stamp is not going to be sticky at all, don't be afraid of that. And now I'm going to do some foiling. Just because Nuvo glue, when it dries, becomes sticky, it's great for sticking foil on top. So we are going to turn this background into a beautiful, shiny background. So I'm going to use these 3 different colors of foil, and of course you can use one color, but I just went mad here. I just wanted to add everything I had, and I'm going to make sure that this is nicely stuck on top of my paper. I'm just using my bone folder there, and now I'm going to peel off everything, and I get a beautiful design. I'm going to try and catch the light for you so that you can see how lovely this background looks. which gives you a totally different ocean background than the one that we have created previously. So now I'm going to stick everything on top. I'm going to stick my mermaid by using some foam squares at the back, and then I'm going to stick all the corals and the seagrasses. I stamped You Are Mermazing from the same stamp set, and I'm also going to stick down all the fish that I have already cut out. Now I also went all over her and added some glitter with my clear glitter pen, and you will see photos at the end where you will see how shiny her tail is. Now I'm going to stick that panel on top of a standard card, and I went with white just to bind everything together with a white border around the images, and you can see how different those two cards look, although they are both pretty much ocean scenes. And here are all the 8 cards that I have created for today by using products from the May release by My Favorite Things. And these were the cards for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. Don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Let me know which is your favorite card of all the 8 that I have created today. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so already, and also if you need more inspiration, click on any of the 2 videos on your screen right now. Thank you all for watching!